that the nation had been waiting for. Who would win Maddie J's heart? And in the dramatic Bachelor finale, Maddie J confessed his love for Laura. From the very start of the season, it was clear she was the favourite, who'd be there right until the end. After all, she did get the first kiss. While Maddie and Laura spend their morning together, we thought that we'd get the runners-up to take us inside the cliffhanger. Please welcome Elise, Tara and Florence to Studio 10. Ladies, thank you so much for being here. Yeah. Excellent to have you with us. Elise, first of all, was it hard to watch your final moment with Maddie J last night?
Oh, gosh, it was hard. It was like reliving it all over again. But hopefully this is the last time I have to see it and it's done.
Mm. Well, look, I think I speak for all of Australia when I say he obviously made the wrong decision. Elise, at what point did you know that Maddie wasn't going to pick you?
Look, it's really not over until he delivers the final blow, but I think walking up there, I had a bit of a suspicion, and then looking in his eyes, I knew it wasn't the same Maddie.
And then he went for the cheek, didn't he?
I just stood there, and I was like, oh my gosh. Wow. And he kind of did the awkward hug thing, and it was a bit of a car accident in the end.
Friend zone.
Yeah, friend zone hug.
Elise, as viewers, it seems like a short period of time, though, to fall in love with someone, but you did say on the show you were having feelings from him, falling in love with him.
I absolutely fell in love with Maddie, and that's the thing about The Bachelor, is the feelings are so real. Mm. And it's a short amount of time, but you just concentrate on love. And I did, and unfortunately, it didn't work out in the end.
And because falling in love so quick seems so hard. Do you think you can fall out of love so quickly and get over him?
Don't they say it takes half the amount of time of being in love to get over him?
How long has it been?
I think it's
very wise.
Yeah, we're getting close to it. We're getting close.
Actually, I think the saying is the best way to get over a man is to
get under someone else.
Yeah. Hey, let's have later.
Have you found love again?
Have I gotten under someone else? Personal. Look, I'm not in love with him anymore, and I haven't moved on yet with anyone else. You know, you have to keep the illusion up that I could be Maddie J's girlfriend. But look, I'm not in love with him anymore, and I'm ready to get on with life.
And you still, even like when you're sort of outside the bubble of the show and you're back in the real world, and obviously a bit of time has passed, do all the feelings you had on the show still feel real to you, or do you sort of feel like, oh, that was just sort of a strange dream? Like, do you still think you were in love with him at the time?
A lot of people ask that, and I knew at the time I wasn't going to say it unless I could truly hang my hat on it myself and believe that I was in love. So I did, but watching the show, it has helped me get over it.
Yeah.
I think it's not like I fell back in love with the guy watching it.
Yeah.
So it was good.
Excellent.
Tara, you were a bit of a fan favourite on the show. Why did you insist on bringing your sausage to chat with Maddie?
Oh, so I was vegan for 2 weeks in the house, so that was my first bit of meat I had in 2 weeks, and it was so good. I can't even tell you how good that sausage tasted. So, yeah, I just wanted to bring it with me. Isn't that normal?
I haven't been on dates where the girls have brought a sausage to the date, but yeah, I think that's normal.
Yeah.
Chris, you on a date like that?
Do you ever bring your sausage to a date, Chris?
I was so going to say that, but that is below the belt.
I take it everywhere.
Literally.
Yeah.
Tara, would you consider becoming the next, because there's a family tradition, obviously, in Australia, becoming the next Bachelorette?
I don't think I have it in me to you've got to be pretty tough to let people go. Like, I think it's easier to be let go than to let other people down, and letting 20 people down isn't going to be easy.
We had Matty J on the show yesterday, and he said that it was just amazing going through the thing where it was basically just, you know, a piece of meat in a lineup to suddenly he was in control. Like, you could take revenge on the entire male species.
Yeah, but I don't know. It would be really hard. I just don't think I have it in me. I don't like upsetting people, and unfortunately, you have to upset people, as you know, we saw with Elise last night. And I, you know, broke my heart to see her upset, and I don't think that's something I could do to someone who's a nice person.
Well, certainly nothing like any of my ex-girlfriends.
Florence, I've got to ask you, have you recovered from your experience on the show last week?
Yeah, I've had some professional help, and
Well, you're going to need some more.
Yeah. Oh, God, send me
a star with my eyes.
That's hectic.
I know.
Oh, have you seen that before?
Yeah. And again, Florence, just...
Oh, God! Oh!
I can't wait.
No, no more, no, no, no.
And can I say, Florence, on behalf of the show, thanks again for not reporting us to HR. We really appreciate it.
Thank you,
Florence, what do you... why do you think he picked Laura in the end? Because it would be a hard decision for Maddie, all that time meeting all these different girls and then having to make the decision at the end.
Yeah. I don't know. I think it's something that you feel. It sounds so cheesy, but it's up to him. No one else can make that decision for him. And if he falls in love with someone, I mean, I fall in love with people and I'm like, wow, how did that even happen? But it's something that you can't force. It's not like you pick a girl and you're like...
You could just pick.
Yeah.
Yeah, that would be really good.
So, yeah, that's a tough question, but she is an amazing girl and she's a good friend of mine and I can totally see why he has fallen in love with her, but... Yeah, at the end of the day, it's something that's very personal.
Well, it's time to check in with reporter David Robinson, who is with our home viewer in Melbourne. Robbo.
Mm-hmm. What have you got for them?
Do you feel more confident on the dating scene now that you've been on The Bachelor?
Good question.
Very good.
100%.
I feel more confident as a person. I guess on the dating scene that would bring confidence just because, you know, we all went in there being our complete selves and with such a positive feedback from the viewers, it makes you feel really good about who you are.
And Elise, you as well?
Yeah, absolutely. I learned so much about myself in this experience and even the kind of guy that I want and what I need. So, definitely.
And for the guys out there, are all three of you ready to know? Ready to date?
Are you asking? Are you asking?
I asked the question. Yeah, are all three of you ready to go on a date?
We're all single. Do you all stay friends after the show? Because obviously you sort of pitted against each other. So it's
not everyone stays friends, but...
Do you stay friends with Maddie J?
Well, I guess I have to, as I'm friends with Laura, but that's fine. I wasn't in love with Maddie, so I'm happy to stay friends with him.
Will you be friends with Matty as well? All of you?
Yeah, of course, I've got nothing against
him. What about the other girls? Who do you hate?
I don't hate anyone. I think hate is a bit of a strong word.
I've got my dislike.
No one in particular. I just have, favourites and... Not so favourites.
I guess there's people, in a group of 22 girls, there's going to be people you have more similarities with others. And then, obviously you're just going to be closer with them, but no hard feelings towards anyone else.
It doesn't make someone else a bad person just because I can't get along with them. It doesn't mean that they are bad people.
I've always thought it does.
it's a tough question to answer, but I don't hate anyone.
No, that's absolutely fine. You just cut their brake cables and let it go.
Ladies, absolutely brilliant to have you with us. And look, can't wait to find out who your next date's with.
Yeah.